How are you today? This is your pastor, Peter Christian Hessing, again, and thank you for joining me here. Such a beautiful day, and I pray to God that God is, and Jesus, and Yahweh, Jehovah is blessing you, and all things are going well with you. And as I always say, if you don't know, and you don't have, and things are not going that well with you, as Jesus says, ask and it shall be given unto you, seek ye shall find, knock and it shall be opened unto you. Now the God we have is a loving God. I mean, if you think that Yahweh, Jehovah, God, Allah, he created this beautiful universe and this beautiful planet. And today I am out in the park. You see all the beautiful trees. I thought I would come out in the outdoor so you can see all the beautiful trees here. This is the park in Douglas, Arizona. Douglas is a small city on the Arizona Mexican border. You can walk from Douglas into Mexico. There is a very beautiful city. They're a very peaceful town. You know, people tend to have these negative feelings about border towns, but Douglas, Arizona is a very peaceful town here. It's also a very Christian town, as I've been telling you that Douglas has a lot of churches, and Douglas has the Guinness World Book records for having the most churches on one block. They have about four churches on one block. They have a Baptist church. I can show you one of the churches over there. You can see a bit of it. I think they're having the Bible study today. That's one of the Baptist churches over there. And then if you go across here, you see another church over there, which is a Presbyterian church. And if you go around the block, you'll see another church, which is a Pentecostal church. And then on the other side of the other block, making it the four churches, you have a Methodist church. And there are other churches nearby. We have a very popular Catholic church, Immaculate, up the street. And then we have a Faith church there. So you have about, I would say, 4 to 6, 7 churches. In the space of two blocks, you have about 6 to 7 churches. Also a Church of the Nazarene there. So Douglas has is a very Christian town. It has the Guinness World Book records for the most churches on this blog. It seems as if, you know, whenever we start making these videos, you know, you get the old town comes and that's the ambulance running there. It seems as if once we start up, you know, you have all of the, everybody gets excited there. My friend here, who is also a pastor, he started a Baptist church, and started very small 2 years ago, and you know, the church that was grown, and now he was able to get one of the largest church facilities in the city. This lot is, and church is so huge now that you can park about 100 cars. You know, it has its own parking lot. You can park about 100 cars on the own parking lot. And this Sunday we're going to be having an opening for that new Baptist church that my friend Pastor Stephen Allen has been able to open up. So God works miracles here. You try to, as Jesus said, you plant a seed. You know, you got to plant the seed. Have the faith. You know, have the faith. So the kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that starts out as a seed, and then it grows to be one of the largest seeds, and then it goes out and is fruitful. It bears 1,000 and 2,000 and 3,000. You know, you start out with a very small, having that faith in God, and God multiplies that seed. So I wanted to briefly continue on talking about having saving the world from nuclear destruction and also reducing gun violence. As I told you, Pastor Peter Christian Hessing, I'm a patented inventor. You know, I've had a U.S. patent. I've gotten into inventions. I like new technology. I think God has revealed to me that God has given us all the technology that we have to solve all the problems. We have technology that we can get rid of nuclear weapons. We can stop gun violence. We can end poverty. We can have health care for everyone, you know. There we can do away with global warming. So God has actually given us the technology to solve all our problems. And you can say that, you know, we might not be able to solve the problem of death, but for that, God sent Jesus Christ here and gave him the technology to overcome death. So God has given us all of the solutions to all our problems. And it's very important at this point that we get rid of nuclear weapons, have nuclear disarmament, and also gun violence. And you have the technology now to do that. That I told you about, I have a new book coming out, the 24/7 safety inspection to save the world from nuclear war and global warming, the nuclear missile boomerang edge. And we have several other books also we're working on. Also have some gospel music that you can get by going to amazon.com, putting in my name, Peter Hessing. And I have two CDs also coming out, President of Reggae Rap Hip Hop and also Miss America Hearts. So I'll be telling you, you know, when you'll be able to get those there. But whoever becomes our next president, you know, whether we have Hillary Clinton or we have Bernie Sanders as our next president, or Donald Trump, or Ted Cruz, or Governor Kasich, whoever becomes our next president is going now to have the opportunity to negotiate a new nuclear disarmament treaty. And it's very important that in this treaty we move towards completely getting rid of nuclear weapons. We have nearly 20,000 nuclear weapons in the world. One of the reasons why the nuclear weapons have not been reduced is one of the reasons has been because of the last treaty that we have has now expired. And because of the crisis in the Ukraine and the crisis in Syria, there has been an escalation in the amount of what you could say the amount of nuclear weapons, you can say non-operational nuclear weapons, or an escalation in the arsenals of the nuclear weapons that the countries in the world have. And as you can see, the other countries now are also trying to build nuclear weapons. You know, you got China, and they're trying to stop Iran, India, Pakistan. So there is a tendency now to have an escalation in nuclear weapons. But we now have to get a treaty that will reduce nuclear weapons towards global zero, which means having zero nuclear weapons in the world. And there's a lot of technology out there. As I told him, patented inventor. Years ago, we invented and designed a system to be part of a 24/7 system whereby the International Atomic Agency would be able to monitor and inspect all of the nuclear weapons in the world on a 24/7 basis to make sure that no country launches a nuclear strike. This would mean that the International Atomic Agency and all the countries that have nuclear weapons would create a 24/7 monitoring system that would monitor and inspect all the nuclear weapons in the world, on nuclear weapons on ships, on submarines, on bombers, on land. Now, this system is not going to reveal classified information. A lot of people get scared, and classified information becomes, you know, so controversial. But this 24/7 system is not going to, it's going to be designed not to reveal classified stuff or top secrets. This 24/7 system will respect the you can say the security and the privacy of all the countries. You know, we have nearly 10 countries also that have nuclear weapons. We have United States, there's Russia, there is China, there is India, Pakistan, there is North Korea, there is Britain, France, there. So this 24/7 system is not going to be, the purpose of the system is not to disclose, classified information or classified emails or, you know, top secrets. So a lot of people get very, you know, touchy about this stuff. You start to talk about governments and military, you know, nuclear weapons, and they start to think about, you know, the top secrets and the CIA and the FBI and the KGB, you know, and all this type of thing, you know. But this 24/7 system is a safety system. It's not, the purpose of the system is not to disclose, it's not going to disclose top secrets or disclose classified information or prying to classified emails. The basis of this 24/7 system is just to make sure that no country launches a first strike or activates nuclear weapons, whether they're operational nuclear weapons or non-operational nuclear weapons in the arsenal. So this system is going to respect the, what you can say, the security, the privacy of each country. And one of the best ways to design this 24 system is to allow each country to come up with a plan as to how they want their nuclear weapons monitored. So each country is going to put forward a plan. You got America, there's Russia, there is China, there is India, there is Pakistan, there is Britain and France, and there is Britain, France, and Israel, and there's North Korea. Now all these countries are going to be able to come up with a system that they want to have their nuclear weapons monitored. So their top secrets, their classified information is protected. So, you know, you don't want to have this controversy about, well, you got a 24/7 system and it's gonna reveal classified secrets and top secrets. This is not the purpose of this 24/7 system. This system is going to be, the real way to do it is to have each country design a system that will monitor its nuclear weapons so that you're not revealing top secrets of America or classified information of America or classified information of Russia or classified information from China or classified stuff from North Korea or Pakistan or classified stuff from Britain or France. You're not revealing or any top secrets. This is a system that is a 24/7 safety system that International Atomic Agency will monitor 24/7 to make sure that no country launches nuclear weapons, to prevent any country from launching nuclear weapons. It is not going to disclose the top secrets of any country. It will respect the privacy and security of each country, because the system is actually going to be done. The best way, I think, I wrote to the United Nations about setting it up, and I wrote to the head of the International Atomic Agency, Mr. Amin Kukuya, about setting it up. And I think the best way to do it is to have each country, have America, Russia, China, India, Pakistan, Israel, all these countries come up with a design. Even North Korea say, okay, this is how we want our nuclear weapons to be monitored. So that and so that their classified information, their top secrets are not revealed. So it's, but this is not a system that's gonna disclose classified information or top secret information, or instead of, what they call the crown jewels, you know, of any country. You know, people tend to get, you know, they you start talking about government, all of a sudden they're talking about classified information, top secrets, and all that type of stuff. So this 24/7 system is not going to disclose or disclose or publish. The purpose is not to disclose or publish classified information or top secrets of any country. The system is just designed to monitor 24/7 the status of each country's nuclear weapons, whether it's on submarines, on ships, on bombers, in space, wherever, on land. It will protect the privacy, and it is designed to protect the classified and top secrets of every nation. So it's not going to be used to disclose to the world classified stuff. It's going to be all the classified and top secrets of any country is going to be kept secret and classified. It is just there to make sure that no country makes the mistake of launching nuclear weapons. So that's one of the founding principles of this 24/7 system. But this is the only way that you're going to be able to prevent nuclear warfare. As you see what has happened in the Ukraine, there where Russia actually started threatening to use nuclear weapons, and well, in Syria, there in the confrontation between America and Russia in Syria, and of course, we have had the Cuban missile crisis and so forth. There, and you see what now they're fearing that Iran now might build nuclear weapons, and they're scared now that North Korea now might be launching nuclear weapons. So, I strongly feel that we have now to take the world community, and all the leaders now have to get together and, you know, decide to prevent nuclear war by building a strong safety system. Now is the time that we have. I don't think that we can take a chance anymore on gambling and hoping and praying that nobody launches a nuclear weapons, because once one country launches nuclear weapons, then all the other countries are probably going to launch, and half an hour the world will be blown up. So I strongly feel now that all the governments, the US government, the Russians, Chinese governments, and all the presidents there of Britain and France and India and Pakistan, now is the time, and the United Nations and the entire International Atomic Agency and the United Nations now to move forward with creating this 24/7 safety system of monitoring inspections to prevent use of nuclear weapons. And if we do that, then we have a very good system that can prevent the launch of nuclear weapons and lead to nuclear disarmament. With a 24/7 system, no country really needs to have nuclear weapons or launch nuclear weapons, because you have a 24/7 system there that will be there to prevent, to monitor and prevent and actually move to abort the use of nuclear weapons. We also need to have a legal system, whether we're going to set up a special court or a special laws within the United Nations or through a United Nations resolution that says, okay, the launch of nuclear weapons is a capital offense, or it's a war crime, it's a crime against humanity, and whether you're going to have sanctions. But you really need to have a special court that will deal with nuclear weapons and all forms of weapons of mass destruction, chemical and biological weapons, and all these other weapons. They're not even talking about laser weapons. They're talking about laser blindness. Lasers now can be used to blind billions of people. So there's a lot. We need to deal with all forms of these weapons of mass destruction, chemical and biological. We need to really have them as crimes against humanity and war crimes with serious penalties, whether you're going to have sanctions imposed, or life in prison, whatever we decide to do there. So this is a time that we have to do that. As I've been saying, that we have really entered the nuclear missile boomerang age, where because of our cyber technology and all the cyber technology, now we have cyber technology, we have cyberspace technology, now we have also cyber terrorism and hacking. What has really happened is that these countries now are able, or people are now able, to hack into these nuclear missile systems and send them back and boomerang them. So we have entered the nuclear missile boomerang age. We have definitely entered the age where it's suicidal now and dangerous for any country to have nuclear weapons, because people can explode them in whatever country they are. And eventually the technology is coming on board where they can boomerang them. They can actually send them back. If the nuclear missile come from Russia, they can send them back to Russia. Nuclear weapons from North Korea, they can send them back to North Korea. Nuclear weapons coming from China, they can send them back. Nuclear weapons coming from Iran, they can send them back there. So we have definitely entered that nuclear missile boomerang age. As I told you, that I'm a patented inventor, and years ago I designed and invented an expanding missile system that can expand, absorb nuclear weapons, actually absorb them, cut them off, and send them back. And that's not something that's impossible. It's not such just science fiction. We can send a man to the moon. We can do that. So we have definitely entered the nuclear boomerang age, where it is no longer advantageous for any country to have nuclear weapons. It's suicidal and it's self-destructive. So we definitely need to have a nuclear weapons treaty from a new president that will have nuclear disarmament. We gotta cut these weapons. We have nearly 20,000 of them now, which we really shouldn't have so much. If we cut 10% per year, in 10 years we have nearly zero nuclear weapons a year. Weapons in the world. If we cut 5% per year, then 20 years we would have zero nuclear weapons in the world. And no country really needs to have thousands and thousands of nuclear weapons. So we have to have a very serious treaty, because as you can see, the nuclear weapons, instead of getting less, they're actually getting more. And it's very sad that we really need to do that. Get America and Russia and all the countries. This time we have to get all the countries together. We just don't have America and Russia alone, but include all the countries in the treaties. America, Russia, China, India, Pakistan, North Korea, Britain and France, Israel. Include all the countries in these treaties, so you have real disarmament. Because as you can see, you're really not having much progress there, because it's just between America and Russia. It's hard, because if the treaties are between America and Russia, and China is going to escalate, and India and Pakistan is going to escalate, you really won't have much reductions. And this is what is happening, because we have just we haven't included all the countries together. And now, instead of we having a reduction, we're having more nuclear weapons being in the arsenal. So we really need to include all the countries. And we also need to do something about gun violence. There are a lot of people being shot down in the streets. Gang violence. There we have nearly with 30,000 people being killed each year in America because of weapons, and also terrorism. We have people going into schools and killing innocent children, people's psychological problems. We have all veterans killing themselves. We have terrorists. See, the only way you're gonna have stop these terrorists like ISIS and Al Qaeda and Hezbollah and Al Nusra and Boko Haram and the Taliban, you have to have some sensible weapons control, and we have to get on our governments and the Republicans and the weapons manufacturers. Now, there's a lot of technology out there that can build safer guns. You can put cameras and into guns. You can put recorders into guns. You can put GPS into. There's a whole lot of technology out there. I'm an inventor, and there is tons of technology that you can put into guns and into bullets and magazines to control them. But the governments and the manufacturers, the Republicans, have to compromise. You know, if they want to stop ISIS, and the only way that you're going to stop these terrorists is by, you have to reduce their access to guns. The reason why we have ISIS out there is because ISIS was able to steal billions of dollars worth of American weapons. So we have to have our manufacturers build guns that are safer, that we can keep out of the hands of these terrorists. And we definitely have to go into the age of recorded weapons and monitored weapons. We can record. I mean, you can put cameras and recorders into guns, and if these guns go into the wrong people, we can shut them down. You know, so the technology is there, and this is not all just science fiction, but we definitely have to get our gun manufacturers and weapons manufacturers to build safer weapons. And I strongly feel that they can do it. The weapon manufacturers, they can build weapons to get rid of nuclear war. They can build weapons to stop all this gun violence and keep weapons away from terrorists. The only way you're going to stop terrorism is to cut off the supply of guns to the terrorists. And the Republicans have to realize that there's stay in the Congress, they want to send more troops to Iraq to fight the terrorists, to fight ISIS. But unless you cut off the weapon supply to the terrorists, you will always have the situation of having to send our children to die in a foreign land. And it comes where I put the blame a lot on the Republicans, because unless you have gun control, you can't stop terrorism without having gun control. You can't stop terrorism and ISIS and the Taliban without gun control. And the Republicans refuse to do that, but they want to send more of our sons and daughters to foreign countries to die fighting these terrorists. You cannot stop terrorism without gun control, and the Republicans don't want to have any gun control, so they are in a dilemma. How are they going to stop ISIS and terrorism without having gun control? You need to have some form of gun control, weapons control, if you're going to stop terrorism and stop having to send our children abroad. That's another topic that I've been writing the president about. We really need to build a robotic army. We'll talk more about that. I also wanted to do a bit of Bible study as a pastor. You know, I got to do a bit of Bible study. The light is sort of, I'm losing my light is getting out, dear. I'm getting a bit dim. But I had started, we started talking about religion, because if you're going to really solve the problems in the Middle East, you have Israel, you have Palestinian problem, you have the problem with the terrorism in Iraq, Afghanistan, Syria, where we have all these refugees now leaving Syria, they're fleeing into Europe. You see, you're going to have a better understanding from a religious point of view also. We talked about the military part of it. Now we have to talk about the religious part of it. You have to make a peace between Christianity, Islam, and Judaism. You see, as I said that I studied Islam, and I am a Christian, and Islam is not against Christianity. The Quran is not against Christianity. As Muhammad wrote in the Quran, there you can read it in the Al-Baqarah, that he said that, you know, you're going to have to accept the Muslims have to accept the Christians and the Jews, because the Christians and the Jews were thousands of years before them. As Muhammad said in the Quran, he said, be a Christian or a Jew, you are rightly guided. The Quran is not against Christians and Jews. It is wrong for a terrorist to tell people to go out and kill Christians and Jews, because the Quran actually teaches that you have to accept Christians and Jews, and Christians have to accept Muslims, because in our Christian religion, you know, Jesus teaches us to love everybody, love even our enemies. And the Quran teaches that in the Al-Nisa 94, that if you kill a innocent person intentionally, or innocent believer intentionally, you know, God is sending you to hell. You know, there's no forgiveness from God for that. So I also want to touch on a bit of Hinduism and Buddhism there, also, because we have a lot of people who are Hindus and Buddhists, and I've been able to study a bit of that also. What I have found out now is that if you go into Hinduism, most of the greatest gurus of Hindus now accept Christianity. You know, yoga, the yoga that is practiced by the Hindus now, are trying to get the Spirit of God, is the same process of getting the Holy Spirit that Jesus gives us. In our faith, we have faith in Christianity, in Jesus, that gives us the Holy Spirit. The Hindus, they have all these yoga practices where you have to meditate, and meditate, and if you want to say sit in a humble position, sit on the floor, or sit, you know, you have to sit in a particular posture and meditate for hours to get the Holy Spirit. So all the great gurus of Hinduism accept Christianity. And the process of yoga is really the process of what we Christians call getting the Holy Spirit, which is we get through Jesus. So Hinduism now has actually become merged. A lot branches of Hinduism have become merged now with Christianity, because we all have to get everlasting life. Life comes not from the body, but from the Spirit. And also, if you go into Buddhism, it's the same thing with Buddhism. Buddhism also has a bit of yoga. You have to get the Spirit, and this is what Jesus gives us in Christianity. He gives us the Holy Spirit, because life will come through the Holy Spirit, not from the body. And this is where Jesus sends us that Holy Spirit that gives us everlasting life. So whether you are a Christian or a Jew, or you're a Muslim or a Hindu or Buddhist, you know God and Jesus came for us all. You know, he gives us that everlasting life. We can all accept God and Jesus and get that everlasting life. So this is your pastor, Peter Christian Hessen. Join me again. I have some videos on YouTube. Please look for my book coming out, the 24/7 Safety Inspection to Save the World from Nuclear War and Global Warming, the Nuclear Missile Boomerang Age, and also my CD, my music coming out. I have some music, some gospel music on Amazon.com that you can get by going to Amazon.com, putting in my name, Peter Hessing. And also, I have some CDs we're working on. Miss America Hearts has 14 of our original songs, was in Billboard magazine. Also, President of Reggae Rap Hip Hop, which has 11 of my original songs, and you're gonna soon be able to get it. So peace and love. Join me on YouTube. You can also get me on Facebook. If you wanna email me, you can get me at peterhessing@outlook.com, or send me a note on Facebook or Twitter there, or get me on YouTube. Thank you, God bless. Give your hearts and lives to God and Jesus. Let us get the Americans, the Russians, the North Koreans, the Chinese, the Indians, the Pakistanis, the Iranians, Israelis, all the peoples of the world, Christians, Muslims, and Jews, Hindus, and Buddhists, bring everybody together and let us get rid of nuclear weapons and have peace and end poverty. We can end poverty very quickly, as I said, by creating a, if you create an online business for all the people in the world, you will end poverty. Let everybody have a business and you will end poverty in the world. And I said to the IMF and World Bank, create 6 billion accounts for all the people in the world, and if you create an online business for everybody in the world, 6 billion businesses, you will end poverty. Thank you, God bless. Peace and love. Give your hearts and love to Jesus. Thank you. Peter Christian Institute. Join me again. Peace and love. Okay. Thank you, God bless. Give your hearts and love to God and Jesus. Jehovah Yahweh. Allah. Peace.